So if you've been thinking ahead, you're probably asking yourself, well, how do I know what's an honest signal and what's not an honest signal? It's a complicated question. I'm gonna give you a few different things. The first one is this. If it seems intentional, it seems dishonest. If it seems unintentional, it seems honest, okay? So let's look at that in terms of talking to a girl. So you're talking to a girl and you're saying, you know, you're really cool and you're saying you have this thing going for and you're saying your place is really nice and that kind of stuff. Well, you have an agenda. You're trying to sleep with her, at least in her mind, and so anything you say is filtered through that agenda of he wants something from me, and so it's not gonna be well trusted. Now, if a friend of yours says the same thing about you that you were saying about yourself, the friend has less of an agenda because he's not trying to get his own dick wet. He's trying to get your dick wet. So he still has a little bit of an agenda, but it's less, so it's treated as more trustworthy. If a girl friend of yours says something, that's treated as even more of a sort of like an honest indicator because the girl has perceived even less of an agenda in the girl's mind. If the girl happens to find it out by accident without anyone telling her, then it has no agenda whatsoever and it will be treated as completely honest, okay? Here's the other thing. Anything you did to specifically try and impress that particular girl is intentional, so it will be perceived as dishonest, okay? So if you are, if you rented a really amazing car that like, you know, looks crazy good and whatnot and she realizes it's like a rental car, that's dishonest, right? Yeah, you could afford the rental car. Yeah, you could like make yourself look good, but it's dishonest. If she happens to find out obliquely because she saw like your friend showed a picture of your garage and there happened to be like a hot car in it and you weren't trying to brag, you have this cool car by accident, not by accident for real because you bought it intentionally, but you didn't buy it to impress her, you bought it for your lifestyle in general, that's perceived as unintentional and therefore perceived as honest, okay? Here's another one. Let's say you are a famous movie star, right? And everybody's seen your movies. You're like Brad Pitt or you're Leonardo DiCaprio or something like that. You didn't become a famous movie star to get that particular girl. Now, quite possibly, funny enough, you may have actually become a famous movie star in order to get girls on a deep level. But at least you didn't do it for that one particular girl, and it's a true fact about your life. And so because, again, you didn't get there specifically to manipulate this one person, it's treated as honest, and therefore it's trustworthy. If on the other hand, you were bragging to a girl about your like movie exploits and she'd never seen one of your movies, then you're try hard, then it's perceived as dishonest, then if anything, it's a turn off, okay? So anything that's intentional seems dishonest, anything that's unintentional seems honest. Here's another example, having a great body. Having a great body, like a good physique, is perceived as an honest signal. Why? Because you didn't theoretically go to the gym just to get that one girl. Now I know a lot of guys went to the gym to get girls in general, but it's not like you could see the girl and be like, hey, I'm gonna go to the gym for 10 years so I can approach that girl. No, you have to go in that moment, the body already existed, okay? So a good physique is an honest signal. Again, saying some clever line to the girl is a dishonest signal because you could have made that up on the spot for that one particular girl. It could be faked.